How do you combat anxiety when you stream? I was just live for 30 minutes trying to troubleshoot a thing, talking about one viewer gave me mega anxiety. What are you anxious over? Them leaving or you boring them? Horizon. Just being boring, honestly? Fuck them! Fuck your viewer. If they don't like what you're doing, they can move on. I'm trying, he's my boyfriend, lol. Okay, Horizon. Bit of a biased audience there. Look, I also struggle with feelings that I'm not being entertaining enough during lulls in the conversation or bits of silence during stream. The thing is, at least for me specifically, I feel like I engage with my stream far more than the average streamer, you know? Every other streamer I've watched, they'll take long pauses, like long, just silent, they'll just sit there, you know? Or they'll watch stuff without commenting for minutes at a time. I feel like I hold myself to a pretty high standard of engagement, which I'm really proud of. But that's my choice to. If I was just quiet for a little while longer, I don't think it would bother a lot of my audience. And I know that because I follow streamers who are incredibly quiet. Lethalfrag will spend like... Lethalfrag doesn't even have a webcam on. It's just mic. And sometimes he'll just go like a minute or two playing a game without saying anything. So you have nothing. It's just silence apart from the game, you know? But I still love watching him because it's chill and I like that. You never had social anxiety? Oh, of course I've had social anxiety. But I don't get it over public speaking, which is what I consider this to be. It's just, look, there are plenty of things I get anxious over, okay? I've taken anti-anxiety meds before. I'm not saying I'm immune to the feeling. I'm certainly not. Not even close. Just public speaking is not one of the things that sets it off for me. Not at all. I actually had a conversation back at Free Your Future Fest. Remember? The Libertarian Expo? You know, when I went on stage the first time, when I was talking with Bastiat, when I walked on stage, I waved at the crowd and said like, hey, hello, how y'all doing? Before I was even at the microphone. And afterwards, one of the people asked like, well, how do you do that? You know what I mean? Like whatever like default impulse you have to just sort of talk at a large crowd of people, just sort of like off the cuff. I feel like a lot of people torment themselves with a fear of public speaking out of sort of weird, insecure narcissism, almost, where they're just like, they think everyone's like really, really latching on to what they're saying, so anything they say is going to be really, really consequential. The truth is, I think for the most part, even when we're a bit awkward or a bit weird or whatever, like, people blow it off, you know? It's just not really that big of a deal. So don't be afraid of taking a few risks when you talk to people. You know, I mean, obviously, there's always the possibility of you catastrophically fucking things up for yourself, but I don't think that's usually what's going to happen. I think usually, you know, what you're really worried about is, like, a bit of awkwardness, which, yeah. Just don't worry about it. Like, people aren't thinking about it that much. People are thinking about their own lives, for the most part. No, I know it's still nerve-wracking, Onidundle. I understand that. I'm not saying that it's dumb... Or like you're stupid if you feel fearful about it, or anything like that. It's a very common fear, and for good reason. At least biologically, our fear of shame or embarrassing ourselves. I know why these things exist. I'm only saying that, you know, I think that a lot of people would benefit from taking a step back. And maybe, I've said this before, but if you're in a situation where you feel you're going to public speak, you know, think about how you feel about others publicly speaking. If you've got a class presentation to give, you've seen other people give class presentations, haven't you? Were you ever, like, latching on to every awkward, like, or they gave every time they lost track of their thoughts and had to recollect, every time they stumbled back over their thoughts? Yes, I was. Well, memes aside, I'd be willing to bet that even if you noticed it, you probably weren't thinking about it more than 10 seconds afterwards. Not unless I'm grading them on it. Okay, well, yeah, if you're grading them on it, it's a different thing. I'm just trying to say that people don't think about you as much as you think about you, obviously, so that's just worth keeping in mind.